And today's exercise is one called the neck pull. And as soon as you hear that, you might be thinking, neck pull. But like many of our Pilates exercises, the name can kind of tell us a lot. I like to think of this neck pull exercise as really a variation of our roll up. And when we hear neck pull, what I want you to think about is neck lengthening. Okay? And traditionally with this exercise, we use a strap for our feet. So if you have a way to anchor your feet, definitely use it. I'm going to show both kind of the full expression of this exercise or some great ways that you can kind of do it at your working level. And actually, let's start with kind of the working level piece of it. So feet and knees about hip width apart. We're finding our tall spine. So if that means you have to bend your knees to start with on this. The first little skill that we want to go over is what I call just like a flat back hinge. And this is all about getting our corset around us, getting our corset engaged, right? Our center, right? Got our stomach pulling up and in, we've got these core muscles engaged to hold us still. And then being able to stabilize our spine as we hinge back and forth. So we're gonna do kind of the traditional neck pull position. Now this position with your head, if you can really take your hands kind of right there at the base of your skull, I'll often take my fingers kind of down my neck, helps me find this. And then have this sense of kind of pushing your head back into your hands, and then your hands just kind of gently lift your neck up. It's a sense of traction. It's not like a yank. Sometimes we hear pull and we think, oh, I really pull. But this gentle pull up, so it lengthens our neck. And then we maintain this position. And then we play around with how far back can I go and still keep that length, right? Back and forth without having to collapse when we go back. And it's a lot of work. You might just get like an inch back. And we want to kind of keep our head pressing into our hands and our hands pressing into our head and that nice connection on there. Now I'm going to show, this is the traditional position for this exercise, but if you were progressing into this, I might have you do it first without your hands behind your head so that you can get a feel for the exercise. And then a little more advanced is going to be to take your hands behind the head. So the sequence of it, I'm just gonna reach arms out in front because this is just like our roll-up, something that we've already done before. Okay, so if we are nice and tall, and we're gonna play with how far can I hinge back at my waist? Maybe that's just an inch or two. And then when I get to what feels like my end range, I'm gonna pull my stomach in. I'm gonna think of my roll down. I'm gonna curl down. This is exactly our roll down, except our legs are apart, and just rolling down through our back. And then the coming back up portion is really just your roll up. You're gonna inhale for half, exhale, you're gonna round your spine all the way over your legs. Now here's where the difference comes in. Now instead of staying low and rolling back, we're gonna first do a little stack up tall. And this is just like our spine stretch exercise that we did. All right, so now we stack one vertebra at a time and we go back into that hinge. Whenever you need, curl and roll it back down. We come back up, it's our roll up. Inhale for half, exhale. I like to start thinking about my spine stretch about right here because this is that spine stretch forward. And then that spine stretch stacking up from my sitting bones all the way up to the top of my head. Now if you wanted to do this with hands behind your head, this is gonna be more challenging. You're gonna work on finding that gentle pull that whole time. Hinging. You might not be able to go as far. And then that curling, so it's just that nice control getting down to your mat as you come back up. You might find that you can go down with your hands behind your head, but when you come up, you're like yanking on your neck. So feel free at this point to reach your arms in front, or if you want to try it here, you can inhale for half, exhale, and again, it's our spine stretch. We reach and round over our legs. We take an inhale and we roll up. We get that nice articulation through our spine, and then we hinge again. When you need to, roll it to come back down. And so that's kind of that full thing. Arms out in front is a great variation of that exercise. So a great exercise for moving through our spine, kind of just a variation of our roll up. We have a little more focus on that neck lengthening, and we add in that little piece of that flat back hinge, which is a great core strengthener as well. So let us know how you're doing with March Madness. Let us know if you like our videos. Be sure to comment below. Get in our drawings all month long. Thank you so much for joining us, and we'll see you back tomorrow.